God. Okay, she was very much an active part of his ministry. What else do you know about Mary Magdalene? Well, it's good that you're here, huh? Yes?
I've heard she was a wealthy woman. She perhaps provided some of the financial support.
Okay. Yes, she was a woman of means, so she helped support Jesus and his ministry. What else do you know about Mary Magdalene? What is she notorious for?
Wasn't she a sinner?
A sinner. A prostitute.
A prostitute.
It isn't true. Yeah. That's what we're going to be learning about. Mary Magdalene, Saint Sinner, First Apostle. Although faith in Western culture is a repentant prostitute and sometimes seen as Jesus' lover and even wife, Mary Magdalene appears in the New Testament as none of the above. There's a recent movie that had Mary Magdalene as Jesus' wife and even had a baby together. None of this is found in Scripture. Before the cross, she is found only once in the gospel tradition, and that's in Luke, who noticed that she had been possessed by 7 demons, but cured by Jesus, and that she and other women provided Jesus' financial support. In all 4 Gospels, she is present at the cross, at the tomb, and she is the sole consistent witness to the empty tomb. As I said in my homily, she's the only person who is at all 3. Not even Mary, Jesus' mother, was at all 3, but Mary Magdalene. Mary Magdalene. The session investigates what we might know of Mary's background in the town of Migdal, how her demonic possession might have been viewed in antiquity, and her presence at the cross and the tomb. We also address her extended conversation with the resurrected Jesus, in which, according to the Gospel of John, she is commissioned to be the apostle to the apostle. That was the gospel that we read today. Now, when I got the call, asked to do the presentation, and there was some interest in doing Mary Magdalene, and they wanted to know if I wanted to switch up the readings. I said, this is a perfect reading for Mary Magdalene. And we turned finally to the development of her legend, the transformation of a faithful follower into a debauched prostitute, and hence a foil, a counter to the Virgin Mary, lover and wife. Mary's name and her home. Now, there are variations of the name of Mary, Miriam, Maria, and so on. When they would hear the name, they would recollect Miriam, the sister of Moses and Aaron, a leader of Israel's exodus in a wilderness generation. The name was very popular in the first century and in the New Testament. Its popularity was enhanced by Mirame, the Hasmonean wife of Herod the Great. Now, the meaning of the name is unclear. Desired child, unruly child, stout. We don't know what the word Mary means. Now, names are always very important. Your question? He didn't have a last name. Nobody had a last name. So in order to identify who the different people were, they would identify them by identified where they were from, what their living was, what who their parents were, where they came from. And so when we have Mary Magdalene, she's Mary from Magdala, as opposed to, you know, Mary the mother of Jesus, or Mary the wife to Cleopas. Mary's home, Magdal, or Midgal in Hebrew, means tower, was a major site for fish processing on the west of the Sea of Galilee, north of Tiberias. In Greek, the city is called Tacharia, salted fish. Josephus, a military commander there at the outbreak of the First Revolt, called it a city. Its Hellenization included a hippodrome. So it was a major city that Mary Magdalene came from. Along with perhaps Judas Iscariot, Mary of Magdala is the only companion of Jesus identified by location. She was unmarried, as far as we know. We have no information that she was ever married. But why was she unmarried? Was she married because of being demon-possessed? Because she was divorced, a widow, or emancipated? Did she abandon her family to follow Jesus? We don't know. We just know that, as far as we know, she was not married. Perhaps she was part of the business world of the male disciples. Magdala is about 6 miles from Peter's home in Capernaum. So maybe she was involved with fishing. We don't know. The first meeting that we have of Mary Magdalene is in Luke's Gospel in the 8th chapter. Luke introduces a number of women whom Jesus cured and who then followed him and supported him out of their means. In addition to Joanna, the wife of Herod's steward, and Susanna, among them is Mary Magdalene, from whom 7 demons had gone forth. Now, what were these demons that she was possessed with? We know. Now, keep in mind, demon possession could be real, actual demons. But any illness was pretty much demon possession, too. We have cases where people would bring their children who were epileptic to Jesus, and he would cure them of their epilepsy. Now, the demons became associated with the 7 deadly sins: pride, avarice, gluttony, lust, jealousy, laziness, and anger. So as time went on, the 7 demons ended up becoming the 7 deadly sins. Now, there's no evidence in the New Testament to any of this. Poor Mary Magdalene had all of this lumped on her.